Japan's economy contracts in the first quarter. According to data from the Cabinet Office, the Japanese economy shrank 2% year-on-year in the January to March period. That's faster than the 1.5% drop projected by economists. The contraction is driven by weak private consumption, which declined for a fourth straight quarter. This complicates the rate hike plans of the Bank of Japan, which raised interest rates in March for the first time since 2007 in a landmark policy shift. Chileans are bundling up as the country faces its most intense cold snap in nearly 70 years. Chile's Weather Bureau expects temperatures in central Santiago to reach a low of 1 degree Celsius Thursday. The change was abrupt, coming within days of summer heat ending. The Chilean government has declared a code blue in six regions in central and south central Chile to help people living on the streets cope with extreme cold. Philippine monetary authorities keep their benchmark borrowing rate at a 17-year high anew. The central bank on its Thursday policy meeting retained its interest rate at 6.5%. Central to its decision is its inflation outlook, as the BSP says risks remain on the upside. It identified potential price pressures, mainly from higher transport costs, food prices, and energy rates. The BSP also lowered its full-year inflation projection from 4% to 3.8%. But next year, it sees a measure of consumer prices at 3.7%. All these as the country's inflation rate climbed to 3.8% in April. Still, Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona says they may begin cutting rates by August. He also says they may lower the ratio requirement for banks once policy easing begins.
We're actually somewhat less hawkish than before, which means we could ease cut rates Q3 or Q4 this year. There was a good number in April, 3.8%. That was mainly driven by rice inflation. But also 3.8% was better than expected. And actually, it's better than it looks because that included some base, positive base effects. So it's actually better than it looks. And then there were other factors that were good news in terms of inflation.
The Philippine Solicitor General's office forms a special team of solicitors to probe the qualifications of Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Guo. Solicitor General Minardo Guevara says the team is gathering relevant information from the Interior Department, the Election Commission, and the Immigration Bureau. He adds Guo could face a quo warranto petition if she is found to be unlawfully holding office. The investigation comes after Senator Rizon de Veras questioned Guo's citizenship due to her lack of birth and school records. In her certificate of candidacy for the 2022 polls, Guo says she has been a Filipino citizen for 35 years and has been residing in Bamban for 18 years. Philippine and Chinese Coast Guard ships exchange radio challenges as a Filipino civilian mission sails to Scarborough Shoal in the West Philippine Sea. A CCG ship also attempted to block the BRP Bagakay, which is escorting the Atinito Coalition civilian mission. The CCG vessels have been shadowing the BRP Bagakay since Wednesday. Despite this, the organizers of the civilian convoy deemed the mission a success after an advance party managed to evade China's blockade and reach Scarborough Shoal. They distributed 1,000 liters of fuel and food packs to Filipino fisher folk there.